All right, part of the Excel at 40 series. This is the fourth episode, this one on AutoSum. That's right, Excel is turning 40 years old, and several MVPs and creators are doing this run-up of 40 features, kind of in order, on our way to the big anniversary. According to Microsoft Telemetry, AutoSum is one of the top five features used in Excel worldwide. Of course, the number one feature is surprisingly paste. Why does paste beat copy? Because there's both copy and paste and also cut and paste, both of course ending in a paste. Paste, copy, bold, save, and AutoSum. A lot of controversy. When did AutoSum debut? If you ask Copilot, it says it was in Excel 5.0, but that's not true. Here's screenshots from Excel 3.0, and Eric Patterson on the Excel team, who was there, confirms it was 3.0 and notes that this right here is the first time any software ever had a toolbar. And there is our AutoSum icon. If you look here, this is Excel 2.0. No toolbar there, so no AutoSum. In fact, it's pretty amazing that the AutoSum icon has not changed in all of those years. Since 1990, that's pretty impressive. I mean, think about some features that keep changing and moving. Analyzed data right here. Analyzed data has been on the Insert tab, the Home tab. Now on the Data tab, it had different names of ideas and insights. But AutoSum has stayed the same for 35 years. Although a lot of people don't know what to call this. This is the sigma symbol. I've heard a lot of different names. The sigma thingy, the summation symbol, the funny pointy Greek E, the easy button, the letter M on its side. Yeah, I never looked at it, but you're right, it is. Sigma alt equals the Greek McDonald's M that's been pushed over. Thanks to all the folks out on LinkedIn and Twitter who gave me those interesting ideas. They say that AutoSum is the gateway drug to more formulas. I say, lots of times, for most people, AutoSum is the first formula they ever enter. So we have a column of numbers here. I want to add those up, and we can just come here to the Formulas tab and hit AutoSum, right? It suggests a formula. We press Enter, and we're good to go. Then you can copy that formula across. You can also, here, press the AutoSum, and it will add across. Press Enter, and then double-click to copy that down, right? So very fast way. Oh, it didn't go far enough. Very fast way to get totals in on the total row and the total column. There are at least six places where we can find AutoSum. It's definitely on the Home tab on the far right-hand side. It's on the Formulas tab on the left-hand side. There's two different quick access toolbar icons that we can add, one with the drop-down menu, one without. You can get there using the Alt equals shortcut, and you can also get there if you select a series of numbers. The little quick analysis thing that pops up, this icon, you can go to totals, and in essence, that is an AutoSum there. There's probably more. Let me know down in the YouTube comments if you know a seventh place where this thing exists. It's amazing, the AutoSum, one icon, it can actually be used to generate sum, max, min, count, average, even subtotal. We'll show you all of those. It definitely prefers vertical. So here, at the bottom of a column of numbers, if we AutoSum, of course, it's always going to give me a vertical sum in all of these cases, even this case here, where I have numbers to the left. Horizontal, though, is a little bit not as straightforward. So here in the top row, AutoSum is going to add across. It's going to add across here, but this one, the third one, is a really interesting one. We have four numbers to the left and two numbers above, and instead it's going to go vertical there. Watch out for that one spot. That's the only spot that has a problem. All the rest of these are going to add across. So it's just part of the prefers vertical thing, right? If it has no clue, like if I just come out here to this total and I hit the AutoSum and it'll be like, I don't know. But it's waiting for you just to take the mouse and choose the numbers and you can get the total in like that. Troubleshooting AutoSum. What can break it? All right, the number one thing that I'm worried about all the time is if I have 5 years and I have headings that are actually numeric, when I hit the AutoSum, it's going to include the year. So you have to be really careful to re-select the numbers if you have a year at the top. So we'll do that again, AutoSum, and then you can probably use that little handle there to remove 2025. Definitely at this point, then drag across. That way it has the right formula. And hey, it's warning you, saying, hey, there's an adjacent number that's not included. All right, oh, yeah, well, that's okay. We're fine with that. Other things that'll break it. One blank cell in the range of numbers. So if I hit AutoSum from here, it's going to get fooled and stop early. Although it's funny, if the blank is immediately above, so right here I have a range of numbers, I leave a blank cell and then hit the AutoSum, it has no problem with that. It will include it, even include the blank cell. Dates. One single date will definitely cause a problem. See, it stops early. Text. If you have text there and you hit the auto sum, it's going to stop before the text. Boolean. True or false. That stops. Here's a merge cell. Ooh, why did anyone merge a cell there? That's horrible. Why do Chris and Diane only have one number? Great question. Stops at the merge cell. All right, here is another sum. So right here is a sum that's adding up everything above. That sum will cause it to stop. Also, a subtotal will cause it to stop. So right here, it stops early. But here is not any formula. So here's a formula of equal 2 plus 5. That has no problem. The auto sum will just include that and go right to the top. So what's the logic behind that? Don't know. How to work around. If you pre-select the range, sometimes that'll help. So here I have a range that has numbers, dates, booleans, another date, more booleans. If I hit the auto sum here, it is only getting the very last number, right? So it's not helping. But here I have a mix of text and numbers, and if I hit the auto sum, it will correctly put a formula at the bottom that goes all the way to the top. All right, so sometimes pre-selecting the range will help, sometimes it doesn't. Here's my number one favorite auto sum trick of all time. People want to put a total row in and a total column in. They put the total here, drag it across, put the total here, drag it down. You don't have to do any of that. Select all of the numbers, plus one extra row, plus one extra column, like that, hit the auto sum, puts the totals all the way around the outside. Here, it is summing across, although that's going to be the same number as summing down. The auto sum does more than just sum. This is crazy. I mean, look at the auto sum. There's a little drop down next to it. Even on the home tab, there's a little drop down next to that one. All right, so if we just come here and hit the auto sum button, it's going to give us a sum function. But if you want an average, come to the drop down and you can choose average. If you want a min, come to the drop down and you can choose min. Max, come to the drop down. Or count numbers, and it doesn't do count text, so there's no count A, but if you want to count numbers, it will tell you how many icons are there, so check that out. More than just sum, we can get sum, average, min, max, count, and there's one more. This one is crazy. I learned this one in Fort Wayne, Indiana. I was at Lincoln Financial doing a seminar for the auditors group there. This is amazing. I'm going to take this data set and I'm going to apply a filter first. So let's filter to everything that's central region. All right, and then down here, I want a total of the visible from this row. I hit the auto sum. And look what it did. It didn't put in a sum function. It put in a subtotal function. The 9 says we want a sum. And this is going to exclude all of the numbers that are hidden by the filter. Now, this operation of getting a subtotal instead of a sum only works if you're in the first row below the filtered data set and if the data set has been filtered. So if there was nothing applied here, like if we clear this filter and then we try and put the subtotal in, it's just going to give us a sum. So you must filter first. See, I just get a sum there. But if I've applied a filter, we'll go to the west. And then here, hit the auto sum, we get a subtotal. All right, so it's an awesome feature. Great way to get a total of all the visible cells. But you have to know to filter first. Now, once it's set up, then it's great. So I can switch here. So we have 4207 in January. If I would switch from west to central and east, then it automatically changes, right? Just a beautiful, beautiful trick there. Here's a cool one. A block auto sum. Select two different ranges, B2 to E10, so, and the blank cell beneath. E2 to E10 with the blank cell underneath. Hit the auto sum, and it'll put a sum in both of those. All right, here's a crazy one. For all the Excel pros out there, tell me how I managed to pull this off. One of the old jokes at Mr. Excel long, long ago was a crazy manager request where they said, hey, can you total that diagonally for me? So amazingly enough, hitting the auto sum here does put in the total of all of those numbers. Let's look down here just to make sure. 42, 49, 42, 49. No, it doesn't really do that. How did I manage to do that? First thing I had to do is I had to fill all the blank cells with zeros. And then when I'm hitting the auto sum, what's happening is they're putting totals in at the bottom and the right-hand side. But I had applied a white font to hide all of these numbers and left that one as a black font. So that is not a real trick. Although I bet you can fool your favorite Excel guru with that one. All right. All right. Well, hey, happy birthday to Excel. It's so exciting, hitting the big 40th anniversary. Of course, the Roman numeral for 40 is the letters XL. So this is the most important birthday, of course, there is. I want to thank the Excel team for inviting me to be part of their 40 days. And I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.